Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, everyone. We from Group 4, Class 6G of the course Math and Grade School Science Curriculum will explain about discussion of question. To shorten time, let's skip to the first material about the question number one. Question number one is, how can you use this knowledge and this skill to make a difference in your life?
Okay, so the answer is, I will apply the knowledge I get to my future, for example, by applying 21st century learning into my life. By applying 21st century learning to my student and hopefully in the future, the student will have critical thinking, be quick to solve problems, think creatively and communicate well in social. I think it's enough to change life for the better for the future. By learning new skills, we increase our understanding of the world around us and equip ourselves with the tools we need to live a more productive and satisfying life. Find ways to overcome the inevitable challenge of life. Most people associate learning with formal education, but learning can and must into a lifelong process that enhances our understanding of the world and enhances our lives. Using knowledge and skills can promote communication, collaboration, time management, critical, creative, and innovative and evaluative thinking. When we want to master new skills, start with proper learning schedules and times, get feedback, start with core skills, take things one at a time, learn from people's experience, and take action.
Number two, do you apply this 4C in your life? If yes, please explain with an example. The answer is, the four of 21st century skill are critical thinking, creativity, collaboration, communication. The four skills are essential for modern student to success in school and the workplace. They often make the biggest impact in terms of setting your student apart when applying for and starting their careers.
Critical thinking is the key of solving problems, among other qualities. In addition to working, solve problems, solving puzzles, and similar activities, critical thinking also includes an equipment of shifting. Critical thinking empowers students to discover the truth in extreme. Especially when I come to sparing of some opinion. With critical thinking, student does learning at a set of parts of figure. Insert the learning how to discover in the parts and pictures of themselves. They ask questions. The come great in the world around them, they have other things critical too. Critical thinking, that right, the most important part to critical thinking. What for the learning how to critical from spending time only or simply asking why in everyday life is to be preferred student of a part of life of independence and purposely still critical thinking is just one of the four 15 21 centers still work just fine when students ask if it alone. But when studies combine it with the next skill, the sky is the limit to what they can achieve. Example, ask question and correct direction making work in the group incorporate this pretty form of it. Contact different details in direct correction and brainstorm.
Creativity. It is trying new approach to getting things done, innovation and invention. The 21st century is an exciting time to get creative thanks to technology. Not only are traditional ways of creativity still available, but there are many new possibilities available. In the current learning process, creativity from students, including in learning. In the 21st century, teachers no longer lecture their students, but educate them to know how to learn or learn how to learn, because basically all the information being taught is already in their hands. Sharpening creativity in children can be done with simple activities. It doesn't need to be expensive, but is able to explore the creativity. For example, the teacher prepares plastic straws, insulation, and scissors. Ask students to make an object that they think is the best. With idea games, students will be encouraged to look for good work, reference from stars, analyze the creation of the reference they get, and create new works from the reference they get. Many simple objects that can be used to hone creativity depend on the extent of the creativity of the teacher to carry out these activities.
Collaboration. Some research have proven that students will learn better if they are actively involved in the learning process in small groups. Students who work in small groups tend to learn more about teaching material and remember them longer than if the teaching material were presented in other forms, such a lecture, regardless of the teaching material. Collaborative learning can occur at any time, not necessarily at school. For example, a group of students help each other in doing homework. Even collaborative learning can take place between students from different classes or from different schools. So collaborative learning can be informal. That is, it does not have to be carried out in class, and learning does not need to be strictly structured. An example of the application of this skill in the learning process in one of them through the project-based learning methods. Through these methods, students will collaborate with each other to work on projects determined by the teacher. And of course, communication will also appear there after the project is complete. Students will provide the result of their project in front of them, the teacher, and his friends.
Communication skills are skill to convey thoughts, ideas, knowledge, and new information processed to others, talk oral, written, symbols, picture, graphic, or number. The dimension of communications can be divided into adapted from Mulya 2017. And the number one is conveying material systematically, logically, and correctly, showing thinking skills. Number two, using good and easy to understand language. Number three, using strategies and media or communication tools that are relevant to the context and audience. And the last is able to analyze and evaluate the talks, ideas of the communication partner and provide systematic and logical response. And the five, self-control and audience. Based on the communication dimension above, this communication skill can be trained in learning. The role of the teacher or lecturer is very important in directing students to train each of these communication dimensions. Communication skills can be trained in learning, namely compiling activity reports, project assignments presentation, group or class discussion, and online learning. That is my presentation of our group about communication in learning. Thanks for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.